Welcome back to Call Dibs, everyone. Today I'm back with another video, and continuing on from one of the previous videos I made, sort of going over some of the awesome music that has come out in K-pop in 2020, we're going to talk about some more stuff today. The B-sides. Today, we're going over some of my favorite B-sides that came out this year. There were so many. I sifted through so much music because it was so hard to keep up with everything coming out this year. So I went back, I did my homework. I listened to literally so many albums all the way through. I think I got a pretty good idea of what has come out this year. Yes, so some of the songs that I did pick, I'm gonna talk about five today, and there's a few other ones I'd like to mention briefly. Some of these songs are probably ones that some people may not expect, but ones that I think deserve more attention because they're amazing and I feel like they're doing their job as far as pushing K-pop as a genre forward, and we can continue to, you know, get some more cool experimental tracks with lots of different pieces, parts, colors, everything in it. K-pop songs in general, I feel like all of the compositions are done differently than a lot of music you would hear in the West, which is why I listen to it, because it's different and there's always something new and something fresh. First song I'd like to talk about is Salty by the Boyz. Honestly, I wanted to add more the Boyz songs on here. I didn't want to put a group more than once on this list, so I just picked one song that I think I like the best, so that's what I did. So yes, I picked Salty by the Boyz, mainly because there were just some crazy chords going on in the song. Like, I don't know if it's like more jazzy or augmented chords, I'm not sure. There were just so many different textured sounds in this song, a lot going on. A bunch of the ad-libs were pitch shifted in different ways. There was like a higher guitar riff going on in the background, just like little bits of ear candy and whatnot. It switched back, there were some tempo changes. I'm not sure if the time signature changed, but it sounded like it. And there's like this super groovy like bass line driving the song. I think it was mainly synths that they used, but it was like a very low high dynamics, but like a very low synth. Plenty of ear candy just to keep you interested. A song I totally recommend checking out. They did a live stage for it. I initially thought it was the single off the album, but it wasn't, and I was shook. But yeah, so I'd say check that stage out and check the song out because it's just insanely good. The next song I included was My Face by VERIVERY. Yeah, I mean, VERIVERY really just got put on the map for me this year in general, just to preface, like, I never really checked out their music up until then, but I realized I'm missing out. But this song specifically just had this aura, this haunting aura bass line that just drove the song all the way through. A lot of lower pitch shifts were in this song. There were ad-libs that sort of had like a walkie-talkie kind of filter over them in the background if you pay attention really closely. And the chorus had like this kind of like whisper singing, but at the same time it was layered with their harmonies but without any effects on them, which was really neat. But the whisper singing also just made it very haunting in general too. And the vocal stacks, the vocal stacks were just amazing. Again, going back to how they had like the walkie-talkie kind of filter over the voice, there were a lot of like texture sound frequencies going on in the back, kind of like if like a TV were to, I don't know, malfunction, and you know, it has like the colored lines and all that stuff, and it makes that like fuzzy kind of like noise. They had that in the background. It was probably some kind of synth that they used, but it just, again, added more texture and more stuff that your ear can pick apart as you listen. Hella harmonies, walking up the scale, and then like closer towards like, I'm pretty sure like the end of the song, it was like there's this dubstep breakdown, all these different kinds of effects and whatnot. I don't know how they pulled this off, but that transitioned into this like beautiful, slow tempo back to the channel of the song. I'm not sure if it was in halftime speed, it sounded like it, or it just slowed down. It sounded like the time signature changed. And it just created this tension that just keeps you on top of the song and just wanting to keep listening all the way through. The next song I included on my list was My Earth by Weekly. And honestly, with Weekly debuting this year, you know, they don't have like a crazy ton of music out, but they've put a decent amount out this year considering the situation that's going on. But this song is very dense. It's very layered. It's layered with like these super thick synths. And while all of that is going on, there's like a ton of tempo changes, again, creating a lot of tension to build and die down and constantly go on this roller coaster to just sort of keep you being pulled in again and again. And there was also, they used some auto-tune, like very emphasized auto-tune in this song a little bit. It wasn't too much. It was just enough, again, to just sort of keep different textures flowing in between frequencies. But yeah, they had only used it on certain ad-libs, which is what kept it very minimal and very tastefully used. And then during the bridge, there was this huge dropout. All the instruments since went away, so it was just the vocals. And then this huge EDM drop comes back in and brings everything back as the full super dense chorus comes back in. Crazy dense song, totally can pick it apart all day long. It's just something that's insane. The next song I have up on this countdown is Wow by Stray Kids, and it was actually by, the song was just, I think it was just Lino, Hyunjin, and Felix on this song. So there was a lot of rap. There was this kind of almost Middle Eastern sounding kind of riff going on, some kind of horn or instrument that kept playing throughout. The song starts very minimal and builds up, adding either some sort of synth or horn. I'm pretty sure it was Lino's part, but there was a small drop that came in right after it. There were these different kinds of flanging synths? Yeah. I think that's how it's pronounced. But these synths are just bouncing around the whole time, again, adding more texture, but they go back and forth between the sort of like Middle Eastern kind of inspired horn and then other just normal synths in this song. Pitch shifted vocals were going on as well. And again, for the bridge, the horn comes back in and it's very prominent, very forward. And then it ends with, you know, a gunshot and then these very gentle sort of keys. But again, great song, totally recommend checking it out. And it was only three of the members, so it's kind of crazy. The fifth song I have on this is NCT's I.O.U. Just to preface this, with all the music NCT has put out this year between Resonance Part 1 and Resonance Part 2, where they included all of the members from all of the subunits, it was so difficult to pick out a song from this because so many were so good, and there's always just something new with NCT. But this song starts with some very, and it continues on, but it starts with some very dense, I'm pretty sure it was like organ keys. It sounded like they could have layered in another key in there as well, so like some like organ synths and maybe some like Rode piano or something. And that just, again, it permeated throughout the whole song as it went on. When you listen to the song, like, it's so obvious right from the beginning. And I loved how they used the rhythm of the song to mimic the vocal parts, the vocals, and then also the rap lines sort of had their own rhythm to it. The beat and the tempo to the song sort of mimicked those lines versus like vocals and raps mimicking the beat. Instead, the beat follows the vocal lines, if that makes sense. So that was really cool. And also it just keeps making tension more and more. It keeps pulling you in, pulling the tension, making you really pay attention. And this specifically is, I think, what makes the song different from a lot of B-sides out there, is just how that beat just mimicked everything. Things are constantly shifting except for the chorus in this song. It still stays consistent throughout. It's very simple, it's very sweet, and it hits where it needs to with an NCT song. And again, with NCT, it's like their main vocalists have, within this song, it also wasn't the whole group. It was just, I think the main vocals on this song were coming from Do Young, Hoon, and then Chenla. So this is a group we haven't seen before, but in general, their main vocalists always have a sort of a specific tone and color that leave you with a feeling of nostalgia, if that makes sense. Like just whenever, even for example, going back to From Home, which was also on the same album, the vocals are just incredible. Super, super soulful, very smooth, and again, it gives you a feeling like you've heard it before, even though you haven't, but it's just always, I expect nothing less than high quality from NCT at this point. Because yes, they have some of the most soulful voices in K-pop, period. And I will fight anyone on that. So those are the five I really wanted to talk about, but some other songs I also wanted to mention were TXT's Eternally, Monsta X's Guess Who, Weki Meki's Sweet Dreams, also a super dense, crazy layered song, Twice's Oxygen, which so hard to pick, and then also Cosmic Girls' Pantomime. Incredible. So those are some B-sides I totally recommend checking out. Yeah, so tell me what your guys' favorite B-sides were this year. Thanks for watching my video, guys. Please be sure to like and subscribe down below. More content coming soon. I hope everyone has a happy holidays and a happy new year. Hopefully everyone's got their New Year's resolutions list because I need to still make mine. So, but anyways, yeah. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Stay safe.